So part 2 of service oriented modeling we are going to discuss today. Before that, respond for this question. It's very simple. Hardly 90 plus students are there. Respond answer for this question. There is option from Tarun. Any other options? But who want to represent? There is option from Niveta. Okay. So the best option would be Niveta's answer. How it would be? Service oriented computing, right? It is something tough to come over that, because it may similar to my BPMN. I will run over on that. Publish, find, bind. They are talking about SOAP, UDDI, right? The three combination, WSDL, XML. That is also related to service-oriented computing. So that will be tough to find out which one could be the best option. So ultimately, for service-oriented computing, we have to map with the publish, find, and bind. Heterogeneous communicating systems. So heterogeneous communication means, I'll be writing a function in VB.NET. I'm ready to call that function within ASP.NET without changing, doing anything. Right? Simply, I'm going to call. So when heterogeneous environments are going to communicate, I need to use the term interoperability. Right? So that could be a very good term being retrieved from Microsoft technologies. Information representation. Right? So how we will represent the information in terms of XML, metadata, right? So it will talk about data, nothing but what does that data contains. I'm ready to give the semantical description of my data. That can be done through my XML. Process description, nothing but that what we are discussing for the last 2 days. Business process modeling notation. Ultimately, it is derived for BPML. So there I will ready to use my, like your UML oriented approach, right? So ultimately the option would be C, right? So that's the case here. So before getting into this session, let us start with a research paper that have talked about this actually. Right, this paper what are all the various approaches are available, modeling approaches are available, right? The next generation of SOA that you must know, right? Microservice architecture. It came on the implementation, right? So even if you take the microservices are being provided by Kubernetes, right? So even you can create your own microservice, not only using already available tool. You can create your own microservice also, right? So when the range of fog computing is carrying over on that without moving for the cloud. I am ready to take the data from the fog itself, or I am ready to use the functionality from the fog itself. So in those cases, microservice architecture will play a vital role. Okay, so that could be the case here. They want to give over on that, but this paper is purely talking about the approaches what they have followed in the microservice architecture. But the literature survey, what they did for this paper is completely, they are concentrating with it. For SOA, what are all the modeling approaches are available? How they have compared, right? So that's what the major discussion they did on this paper. That's the reason why I chose this paper to discuss. Okay. Microservice architectures are ready to float in the environment, not only for one business, even for our ESB, right? Even for enterprise service bus, it is ready to move forward. Right? And one more thing, for SOA, you have to build up the framework, right? So the framework could be, it would not be reusable for other environment. That is the reason why model driven development is being focused as a disadvantage of SOA. That is the reason why you create a framework, but I could be able to reuse my microservice. That's what they want to stress it over right here. Okay. So here, I'll show you a table. The table will discuss about that. So remember that service layers available in SOA is being provided by Object Management Group, OMG, right? Whatever related to SOA will be approved and provided to us by Object Management Group. It is the subset of W3C. It is a subset of W3C. And see here, here it is going to come. Here they are ready to distinguish your what are all the parameters that will make us to move for the approaches. Okay. So when I'm coming for my SOA, the term called service granularity, we have seen this term while we are ready to work with our principles of SOA, right? So you could able to bound here with what are all the related domains? Could I able to cluster it? Is it possible for me? No. That could be the major drawback that service granularity is being focused on. Okay. Second one is interface abstraction. It is nothing about message communication or messaging. Interaction of services with the consumers using different message formats. Right, that could be enabled by the ESB. Right, already I have shown you ESB while I'm talking about service oriented architecture principles, characters, and benefits. Right, that I have shown you. So that will help me. But the drawback on MSA that I have to use the same format such as. But this is the one which highlights my SOA that I could able to use my interface abstraction. Right. So for SOA, the protocols are being supplied by ESB itself. Okay, so that could be the major term. Inter-service interaction, I have different levels of SLIP, service level interaction patterns are available for me, right? So that could be the added case that we are ready to work with. Extra service interaction, right? That what I'm going to communicate outside my ESB. In those cases, they will supply you APIs, but in SOA, I don't have such type of SOAs. A very simple example, right? A very simple example that you could able to check with this. Even in IBM Watson Studio, if you have created, if you have created a service, you can make that service as a extra service interaction. For example, I want to share the thing here. I have developed a simple chatbot using IBM Watson Studio that can be accessed as a extra service interaction. Okay, that can be accessed as a extra service interaction. Right. So this one is somewhat slow. Show you. Yes. And now I will paste this in the chat. Right. You could check with this. Right. Now the things are completely. It's an example for extra service interaction. Okay. For example, if I'm ready to access this. I have not logged in to the environment. So be sure about that, right? So the chatbot is ready to open. Okay. So if I am going to provide my, it's asking, hello, I am a restaurant bot capable of showing menu, find offers, place offers. Can you please give your name and email? So I am supplying Ashok and ashok.pm@ritchennai.edu.in. Right, the bot is right. So it's ready to respond. So such a type of services that if I am going to use, it is ready to provide me the content from the immediate catch. That's what we are ready to talk about fog, right? So it's an example for a extra service interaction that you could be able to try it out. So that's what we are discussing on this application scope, right? Application scope. So already it supports messaging. Heterogeneous communication is possible. So in that case, cross enterprise applications that I could be able to communicate in a easy fashion, right? So that could be the major thing that here we are discussing about it. Again, practice orientation. Practice orientation is completely talking about my the soap or a rest or my corresponding place where I am accessing my service. Everything is completely based upon interoperability. So instead of my using my regular protocols, that could be encompassed with my ESB itself. That's what they'll be talking about. Processes, right? This is the place where we'll be talking about more on microservice architecture, right? So DevOps, so Docker based operations also ready to provide such a type of instances for this, right? So that's a case that it's available for me from SOA environment, but when I'm going for microservice architecture, they'll directly working with their DevOps, right? So DevOps is being the primary level of my Docker operations only, right? So that could be the characteristics that will highlight the service-oriented architecture pertaining to their analysis, design, and modeling, right? So that could be the case. Because while we are going to analyze, what are all the parameters we have to take into consideration? So that's the reason why these characters are being exhibited for you. Service granularity, interface abstraction, protocols, inter-service interaction, extra service interaction, application scope, practice orientation, processes, right? So these characteristics will help me to analyze in the subsequent level, as well as if I'm going for modeling, the same parameters would be helpful when I'm going to move further, right? So these are also the cases that they have tested with some particular architecture. So here you will get the next level detail, what they are planning for this. See, in the year 2004, that's what I have conveyed you, when SOA was being in the environment under research. So in those cases, what they have used as a modeling language, they have used UML, right? They have used UML. Later in 2006, the subsequent language is being designed, 3C modeling, right? So later only, from OMG, they have created the reference model for SOE, right? Reference model. That reference model will help us to understand and build the custom specific environment. So like our OSI layer, right? Already, I think the reference model I have shown you while I'm teaching you the second unit, right? So that's the case. Next, they are ready to incorporate XML in the environment. That's what they are mentioning. A platform independent model for service oriented architecture. That's what they came for this MDA. So that's the approach that they have followed. So then the introductory level of our XML, which was pure completely flourished in 2007. See, they are using XML as a component till 2007. From 2007, the entire SOA environment was built using XML. That is the pace that XML had come into the picture, because till that time, that has been used as a tool, as one of the tool in SOA. But the thing is, using the same tool, they have completely restructured the SOA environment. So that is the case. SOMF, that already I have shown you, that IBM have designed this. In the SOA session also, I have shown you some of the contents. Even today, I will show you some of the discussions that what we are carrying on. So SOA reference architecture was further being modified, and reference architectures are being improved in the yearly fashion, right? So SOML specification people have released using UML. The reason is that you could able to see types of diagrams in UML, right? Likewise, they want to introduce the types of diagrams in SOML also, right? So or SOAD also, that I could able to convey like that. So when specific, see, already we know about that SOA is going to be the platform. Implementation sector is going to be my cloud computing only, right? In those cases, how I am going to arrange my components for the corresponding layer? That is also being done through my XML. So it is ready to give me that. See, what would be the structure of complete AWS? Through SOA, I could able to give you the detailed picture. In this way, that I could able to arrange my components, right? In this way, the services can be communicated. That can be done and performed in a complete way, right? So this could be the ways that what are all the modeling approaches they have followed from the inception, right? So most of the places if you come across, they will take the parameter, they will devise all the parameters into the common metric QoS, right? That could be the ultimate aim, right? So modeling is purely based on messaging. That is the final thought they will come and close in most of the research papers, right? So that could be the thing I want to show here, right? As well as I think that you could able to see that. I think approach number 8 have given you the major revision as well as the content. But approach 8 is nothing but it is ready to realize and own SOAs, owning SOAs. Nothing but it is ready to come for a complete platform for the environment, right? So still now, whatever is being approached as the reference architecture, most of the conventions are being from A3 only, right? So what they have discussed on A3, that if you move further, see that is the basic reference architecture being designed, right? So the improvements are being accepted over on 8. Okay. So service contract interaction. These three will decide you the complete analysis, design, and other relationship. So remember this term, service contract interaction. So these are all the things that are completely involved in analysis, design, and modeling. Service contract interaction, right? So that's what I want to stretch it here. And the next level, just if you're able to see this term, see the term semantic clustering, right? Semantic clustering. This is something what we are doing mathematically in our machine learning or deep learning. But here, semantic clustering, that could be done with the power of XML itself, right? I could able to cluster the similar messages. I could be able to cluster the similar services using semantic clustering. That's what the that was the main takeaway for Microsoft architecture from SOE. Right? So that could be the major thing that had been carried out from the development. Right? So I think they have tested. See, based upon their services, how they have based upon the parameters, data, service, operation. So how they have designed for the case study, what they have followed, right? So that could be the cases, and see that what are the clusters that they have created. See that all are completely related to service oriented architecture only. See that application service, these are all the things that you have come across in your WSDL. Some of the terms are in WSDL. Remember WSDL tags, okay? So some of the terms that you have remember in WSDL tags, completely based upon your WS messaging, WS reliable messaging, right? That you could able to come across these things. See number 17, message exchange pattern, message structure, message type, okay? So message exchange, so these things will come under on that. Remember this term endpoint, that what we have seen, okay? So overall, all these concepts are being involved when I'm going to model a service oriented environment. That's what application service, architectural service, artifact, atomic service, authentication, awareness, all these A's completely depends upon application architecture, artifact, atomic, authentication, awareness. All these things will completely rely upon the architecture neutrality. That's what they're ready to bring, right? Architecture neutrality, that is what they're ready to bring over on that. Along with that, since we are talking about the in chapter 4 security, that's what they're talking about authentication here. So they want to bring those things as a separate cluster, okay? So business service, categorization, consumer, all those things are ready to talk about the utilization environment, right? So further, technical environments are being projected through this endpoint execution context. These two things we'll talk about the technical environment. Rest of the thing we'll talk about from 12 to 21. Right? Even I could use 25. From 12 to 25, purely rely upon our messaging, right? Message communication, messaging, right? So that's the major content there. Finally, 27, I could able to do that. So security management, service description, specification, structure, visibility. These are all talking about. So here I have clustered based upon the environment. Even these parameters are being clustered again, right? 28 to 32, completely rely upon your UDDA, right? Remember, completely on UDDA, okay? So completely rely upon 12 to 27 is completely rely upon your messaging. Even I could able to 10 to 12, right? Messaging. So rest of the things are purely talking about the platform, right? Nothing but my XML, okay? So SOAP, UDDA, WSDL, everything is being created using some tag names. That's all. That is going to be modeled. So if you want to perform modeling, you have to these three parameters, these 32 parameters only. That's what, that could be the case even for SOA or MSA, this is applicable. Right? If it is going to be MSA, I could be able to increase number of clusters. If it is going to be SOA, how I have clustered? From this 32, I have created you only three clusters. One cluster is for SOAP, one cluster is for WSDL, one cluster is for UDDA. Right? So that could be the major discussion on this paper. Right? So suggest to students, this paper is a very interesting paper that even you can see, for example, you are going to create a service-oriented environment or service-oriented architecture along with the service-oriented computing that you are going to create for a supply chain restaurants or supply chain based some big retail stores. So in those cases, what are all the parameters that are necessary for your modeling, right? See, very simple. In OOAD, you will be following that 9 diagrams. The same way that you are going to create the diagrams using these clusters, right, for your design approach. So that could be the case that I want to talk about here. interesting, right? So continuing with that, right? So these are all the things it can be used, right? It can be used. Then you could be able to see this type of things in the BPEL, right? BPEL node windows that you could be able to see, that would be available. Even that can be clubbed for the corresponding environment, right? So collaboration, composite service, enabling technology, information model, message, node template, node type implementation, participant, provide port, service component. Again, see, if we take out all these things, again, they will come and fall within these three clusters only. So UDDA, WSDL, right? So in those things, see, while you are going to do modeling in your object-oriented environment, you will concentrate on functional requirements alone. But when you are going to do modeling in SOA, you have to concentrate both functional requirements as well as non-functional requirements. That is the major thing that here we are going to talk about this, right? Non-functional requirements are nothing but the things which are completely based upon services. Functional requirements are nothing but what are all the major business logic that we have to concentrate, right? So that's what the major two use cases that we have to think about in SOA, right? So that's what the thing on this, even I will share this paper today while I'm uploading the today's PPT, right? So it would be, and I want to convey you interesting book for you that will talk about completely the difference between the SOA and the yes, here it is. See that reference number 19. Right? So microservices versus service oriented architecture. So here they will yield you the complete orientation, how the transition had happened from SOA to MS. Right? See, again I'll be telling you, in MS, most of the contents are from SOA only. There are no new concepts in MS. It is being clustered. It is being very specific, application specific. It would be combined over on that, right? So if you are going to construct a modeling language, if you are going, the ultimate aim of this paper is why we have studied all these type of modeling approaches is, if you are going to construct a modeling language, I have to concentrate on these 48 parameters. If I am going to concentrate only specific parameters, it is going to be microservice. If I am going to cluster all the parameters and I am going to use them, that is going to be my service-oriented architecture. This is what the complete orientation on this paper, right? So this is the paper one that I want to discuss here, right? So this is the second paper, paper two, that I think after traversing the PPT, we will come over here, right? So yesterday we have discussed more on this, right? So what are all the parameters that we have discussed over on that would completely rely upon this environment? But where these all these parameters will be identified in the left side, that you could be able to see modeling language, right? Within that, all these 48 parameters can be available as tags. That's all. Using the tags, I could be able to manage those environments, right? So that's the major thing that I want to talk through this diagram, right? So till now, whatever we have discussed, that is being transformed into the theoretical term here, right? How I am going to create my conceptualization, what is the architecture I need to follow, discovery of services, how I am going to analyze the necessity of SOA for my business, how to integrate my design. So what could be the logical architecture that I have to design, right? So pertaining to modeling language, for analysis, what are the models are available, that what I have to use. So analysis proposition diagram that I have to use. So when I'm coming for the second one is service oriented logical relationship diagram. remember your UML diagrams. Likewise, in analysis, we have very specific diagrams, and for design model, we have some specific diagrams. So using that, I have to design the corresponding use cases. That's what here. So service oriented business integration diagram. Remember this diagram names, right? So but while you are going to use your BPMN or BPEL, that these things will be available as a menu, right? Analysis model diagrams, everything will be available as in the container. Just a plug and play, drag and drop, that you could be able to use it. Service oriented logical composition diagram. And so SOBID, SOLCD, so service oriented diagram. So all these diagrams are responsible for the analysis phase and design phase pertaining to modeling. Right? So modeling consists of these things, analysis and design. That's the reason why in our syllabus they have given analysis, design, then they come for modeling. But we don't have any blind theories on analysis and design. Once we start learning about modeling, what are all the analysis parameters that we can include? What are all the design parameters that we can include? I have introduced all these parameters through the research paper. Okay, that can be transformed into the corresponding content here. That's it. Right? Architecture model. Right? So these are all the architectural model that I have to follow. Conceptual architecture, utilization diagram, transaction directory diagram for logical architecture. So these are all the models that you need to remember, right? Analysis model, design model, architecture model. So these are all the things. Likewise, I have some patterns also. How I have seen my service level interaction pattern in SOA. In service oriented computing, these are all my patterns. Discovery and analysis roadmap patterns, service identification patterns, service categorization patterns. This is the place where the process of clustering will happen. Service categorization patterns, contextual analysis and modeling patterns, structural analysis and modeling patterns, right? I have to choose for my corresponding cases. Once we familiarize with the tool, I think the very good certification for this paper is IBM 699. Now it has been renamed as IBM 9150-699, right? Type here IBM 9150-699. It is an interesting certification from IBM. It's the name of the exam that what I have typed in the chat. This is the name of the exam that you can approach for the certification details. I think due to the pandemic period, certification rate has been reduced. They are testing your SOA fundamentals pertaining to this modeling, right? They are testing the SOA fundamentals. So you will get only 65 questions. Among that, 30 questions are from SOA fundamentals. What we have learned in unit 2, right? From that, what we are learning in the unit 5, these things will come under the first section, first 30 questions. Rest of the things will be concentrating on completely that, how XML is going to be deployed, or what is the modeling language. When you are going to get registered for this, you will get the dumps notes from the IBM itself directly. So there you could be able to get the IBM modeling language, SOMF, that what I'm showing you. What are all the diagrams are available? What are all the notations that we are going to use? So that certifications will be useful to understand and move forward, right? So related to modeling, that's what I want to stress it here. So this is the modeling styles that, see, this will be available as icon. So how the services are need to being communicated, how my functional requirements and non-functional requirements are need to be communicated, arrangement, or that we could able to say that a very good term, orchestration and choreography that can be done through this SOMF styles. So there are four styles are available: network, circular, star, hierarchy. You have an implicit meaning is there. Network, you could be able to see that. That is a relationship or hash a relationship, right? So that it is going to be your inheritance or it is going to be your aggregation. That could be the major piece, right? So star, that is going to talk about your types of relationship on MSTN, N1STM, So depending upon the four types of relationship that I could able to move forward. Circular and hierarchical, that is, they are ready to move for the complete reusability of the existing services, right? I'm going to add up a service with the existing service. In those cases, these types of styles can be followed. So you have to choose the corresponding style on this, right? So by this, I will stop here. If you have any queries, you can post it in the chat.